So guys, it's me, Zero, here, and I'm here not with one, not two, but three impression videos that I did earlier, but I didn't actually, flesh out. I didn't flesh out more, and I decided, you know what, let's go the extra mile, let's add some gameplay, and add, like, what I actually want to talk about, because... yeah, there's a lot to talk about here, and let's start strong with, because a lot came out, like, last year, like, towards the end, like, in December, and then, like, now, in January, like, the last demo came out, but, anywho, I'm trying to keep this short and sweet, and divide it into, like, multiple parts, so don't be surprised, like, you hear one thing in, and transit to another one. So let's start off first with the first demo I played, which is mind you, these aren't like first impressions, these are just impressions in general, because I'm like, okay, I like, it can't be first impressions, this is my multiple times going back and playing these, so yeah, a little forewarning. But anyway, the first demo I ended up playing was Nier Automata. And let me just say, like, that blew me out. Like, I already knew it was gonna be like I was interested in it. Like, I knew I was gonna get it, but the demo just helped cement that. And also, like, my little backstory with Nier is that when I watched demo actually got into me on Demolition D. He got me into it with his Dragon 3 review, Dragger 3, however you pronounce it. He basically, at the end of it, he said, there's a video of the recommend Nier, and I ended up getting both, though. I got Dragon 3rd because it was, like, $23 and on sale. Then I got, the Japanese voice pack because it said playing Japanese, too, because they did more. And, as far as Nier one, got that pre-owned, and 7 hours in, and I love the story and the soundtrack. The soundtrack is like god tier, and the only takeaway I have to say was like the combat was just like very mediocre. And demo also brought up the fact that Yoko Taro never makes the same game twice, and it really does show here in Automata. Like, when you find out the story of how their machines rebel against, other machines, that's out to do them harm. Like, it's very, very, the atmosphere is, really gray, I say. But, let's not dive too much into that. the combat was a very, very nice improvement on the first game. Like, it really was. And basically, it's Platinum's and him, and like, the combat's like very fast paced, as you could probably see, like, while I'm getting my ass kicked. And I'll enjoy like every minute of it. Like, they, like, I haven't felt like this much, felt this good about like action from a Platinum game since Bayonetta 2. And the one before that was the 1-for-1-on-1. So yeah, they really struck it here. Like, you have Platinum with your game with the combat, and then you got Yoko Taro with the story. So I'm like, it's like the perfect match. It really is. And yeah, I really liked what I played of it. How the countering works, how you can either choose to go like light or heavy. They got a cannon for God knows why. And, I especially like the banter between, 2B and C, sorry, Kogios fans, no, 9S, especially, is when the demo is playing. Like, I probably got, bits of it, playing right now, but, yeah, I really enjoyed that a lot. I'm always a sucker for character, attachments, stuff like that. Like, being able to attach to a character and then having instead of like them just being like, oh, we have this goal and let's just go here and not like interact with each other or form like some type of bond. They actually form a bond here. Like there's something going on here. And by the end of the demo, I was just like, wow, that's just wow. So yeah, I'm definitely on the lookout for this. Like, if you haven't tried the demo, I highly recommend you at least try it. Like, if anything, just get it because, like, Platinum's working on it. Like, the A-Chain. Not that B-Chain that's worked on Star Fox Zero and all those other mediocre licensed games. But it's definitely worth a shot. And after saying that, I literally had to go back and finish the original. Like, literally. Like, I have to do that. Principle, not only principle, but I literally have to beat that game because, yeah, sequel is. And speaking of party banter, that leads us into the perfect segue, Tales of Berseria, and oh boy, do I have a lot to say about this. Mind you, if you haven't noticed or you haven't heard. I'm a massive Tales fan. I've been a Tales fan since Tales of Symphonia. We don't talk about that sequel because we all get sad about the missed opportunity with that one because we can't have nice things. Tales of Vesperia, I ended up getting that after the disappointment of Star Ocean: The Last Hope, and after I beat Final Fantasy XIII, don't question me on that, like why I did that, but yeah, that was favorite cast to date, and not only my favorite cast to date, but Yuri's my favorite Tails character to date. No Tails characters has topped him, like, as of yet. And then afterwards, I got into, since I got my PS3, I got Tales of Grace F, which was the definite version of Tales of Grace, which was originally released on Wii, but we didn't get it, so I love the characters, the combat, and that. And then we got Tales of Zelia, which I can't stand to this day. Like, everybody else sings its praises, but me, no. I hate it. I hate how, I won't say I hate it, I'm just don't really like it that much. Brihard got the, like, we shared the same thoughts on that. Like, he basically explained why he didn't like it, and I didn't like it either, because it didn't have that Tails feel to it. Like the other ones did, like, they could just connect to you, like, that's what they did. And this one basically was like, oh, okay, he's basically, like, you take Jude out, then you basically, he's basically a backseater. That's what Jude is, a backseater. Anywho, that got a sequel. I didn't play that because I learned my lesson with that. And as far as Tales of Zestria went, haven't played it. My brother had it when he first bought his PS4, and I saw him play it, and I'm like, yeah, I can't get behind this. So this, now I have second thoughts about that because this is basically a prequel to said game. And my rule is, like, if I play a prequel, I basically gotta play the rest of the game just sequel. So, yeah, I'm basically gonna have to go back. When it gets lower. When it's fucking on sale again, probably. But, anyway. Tales of Berseria is, like, this wasn't my first time. I played it before when they announced the Japanese demo. I made a Japanese PSN account. I played it. And I enjoyed the, even though, like, I didn't understand a lick of Japanese, I enjoyed the combat. I, like, at least knew what buttons to press and whatnot, and I really enjoyed it. I loved the combat, and I was like, this is what I was missing. Like, this is what Zelia lacked, and why I didn't like Zestria so much, because Zestria didn't really have that much either. As far as, like, playing it in English, it was so much better because, I actually found out what I had to do, what the instructions, the tutorials told you, like, what did what, how the system works, how the soul system work, guard, black, and how, oh my god, there was just so much going on. I'm like, see, this is the kind of type of combat I could get behind. Like, even though it may be hectic as hell, like, at least I'm having fun. Like, this has the combat system of where, if, like, I just got into, during the first time I played the demo in English, I just got into fights just to get into fights. Like, I just ran into, like, anything because I enjoyed the combat that much. And then we have, our main character, Velvet, who's, I like to call the female Ragna of the Blood Edge, because that's what she basically is. She's going around with her little fucking demon claw hand, and help, like, as soon as they introduced the mechanic of, like, that was what had me grinning from end to ear, ear to ear, to be honest, was the whole mechanic of, oh, you can still, like, you could, like, when an enemy is casting a spell or whatnot, you can press this button and it'll interrupt them, like, and just give you, like, this boost or whatnot. And hers is basically, she devours some stuff. I don't know if she get, like, added STP or whatnot. No, we don't use TP anymore, but, health or whatnot. But, yeah, I found that interesting. Another character you probably already know by now that I use a lot is Megalo, and her thing was, she's basically the mage, and I like to joke that she's basically Rita's successor, Rita 2.0, because like Rita, I like her character design and her character, and I like playing with her a lot. I really did. And her thing was that her R2 thing was that she's that she could steal magic and use it back at him, and I did that a lot. I really enjoyed doing that. Like, it even shows, like, in the video, I did that a lot. And her Mystic Art too, and it was just so much. This game was, like, so charming. Like, it's like, there's this victory pose with Velvet and the red haired chick with the spear that just has them, like, acknowledge each other, like, and I found that hilarious, like, adorable. And then there was another scene with, Megalo talking to, like, showing the boy off, like, her tricks and whatnot. But the most of the stuff that happened, like, in my first run. Like, a lot of stuff happened, like, them questioning, like, Megalo's dress and, like, what she was doing. So, like, I kind of wish I would record then, but I'm like, I want to enjoy this first beforehand, so. And the game comes out Tuesday, so it's been a while since I've been excited for a Tales game, to be honest, because, like I said, Zelda left a bad taste in my mouth, and Zestria, I haven't tried that, but the DLC for that kind of ruined all my interest for how they handled that. You know what I'm talking about. Don't even try to defend that. But, yeah, I'm really looking forward to this one. And hopefully it'll be worth it. Oh, and I also have Tales of the Abyss for 3DS, but I don't talk about that one. Last but not least, Gravity Rush, and oh boy, this one. Okay, alright, I haven't played the first one. And I said, I'm not getting the second one until I get the first one. And the first one wants to be a bitch and not be, like, really accessible to get. Well, I wouldn't say that, but, I was debating either get the physical or digital version, but, you know, that's a personal problem. Anyway, when I first played this, and you probably seen it now, I did the beginner's course, and I was basically getting used to, like, everything, like, moving around, just aiming where I want to be, and I found that to be, like, awkward at times, and then it's other times it was precise, and I was like, wow, I see how people felt about this, like, playing it on PS4 for the first time. And, yeah, there was this one section that I don't know why I didn't record, but, there was one section in the beginner's course where you literally have to start landing, like, in the air, while you're in the air, like, stop in the air, then land, like, precisely at the spot, and I could not get that for the life of me. I was stuck on that for so long. I was like, thank God I didn't record this. People would have been like, either bore it out of their mind or literally like time stamp it and be like, wow, this guy sucks, or get good, like, and then they'd be right. So I didn't want, you know, to deprive you guys of that. You get to see that in like more videos, trust me. Yeah, I did that a lot, but this time I did the experience course, I believe. So this is all this from the experience course, and I didn't even know it was two different things. I was like, oh, this is good at the boss at the beginner's course, and like, no, we have to keep going, but I cut off halfway through. But anyway, this was just it's a new experience, because I was like, okay, all right, this is cool. Like, combat's very simple. Square is your attack button, and R2 is your dodge. You could use circle to pick things up around you, and then circle again to throw at them. You can find while you're in your gravity phase, and just homing attack them homing kick them. And something you'll notice later in the video is that there's a mode activated called Lunar Mode. Is it Lunar? Lunar Mode? But yeah, that got activated, and I was like, I don't even know what the fuck this is. Like, this is the first time I'm hearing about this, and you're now telling me this now instead of like in the beginner's course. You could at least tell me like that, because I was literally confused on how to activate it and how to turn it off. So yeah, that's literally in here. Like, I was really, really confused. I'm like, this is supposed to happen. I'm like, this is supposed to be the end. Like, after I beat the boss and destroy the cargo, like, no, there's more to it. So yeah, it's a different game. I say that much. But, I was interested in it when it was, first it was announced for Vita. Like, that was gonna be one of the games, like, it still is in my Vita wish list. But after they announced that it was gonna get a remaster for the PS4, I was like, well, we know what the sequel's coming out to, because, you know, the Vita's basically dead here. It's dead here, still thriving in Japan, and we're still getting games on it here, but not as much as Japan, though. Like, I think we're, like, close to, though, but, not too sure about that. But yeah, that's basically been me. I did enjoy, like, the atmosphere and dialogue and whatnot. It gives off some very, I'd say anime-ish vibes. I don't want to offend people who's like, this is not anime. Like, come on, guys. Like, it's very colorful. I'll give you that much. Very colorful, lighthearted cast. And only takeaway I gotta say so far is that if you just stay at the opening screen, like, it kind of, like, it's spoilerish, I guess. Yeah, that's my only complaint so far. Like, the opening screen is kind of spoils a lot. I also got Ni No Kuni vibes for it, even though, like, I wasn't a big fan of that. Like, I'm gonna attempt it again to try to get into it, but yeah, basically it was that. And even though it's out, like, this was the earliest game to come out, like, out of the three demos I played, like, this was like, okay, this is literally gonna be out during this time, like, literally January 17th, I believe. This came out the earliest, when Tales of Berseria coming out like a week afterwards, but that was it. Like, I was like, I can't get the sequel till I beat the first game. Like, it makes no sense to, like, literally jump into the second game and be like, okay, now I'll go back to the first one. No. Too many times I did that, so I enjoyed my time with this, and hopefully when I get caught up, like, on the first game, the second game's gonna be cheap, because I don't, or whenever I get the chance to, I'll pick up the second game. So there we go. That's it for my impressions video. So lots to look forward to, and don't get me started on, like, the other games coming out. Hopefully they get demos. Hint, hint, Atlas. Hint, hint. But other than that, thank you guys for watching. See you guys later, and keep it classy.